Hi students, this is Rajendra. So we are going to discuss about IUPAC nomenclature. So here some basic rules are there for the IUPAC nomenclature. So what are the basic rules? Let us discuss once. So in that the basic rules, the first rule is, so while giving the IUPAC nomenclature, first we have to select the longest carbon chain. We have to select longest carbon chain. So this is called parent chain or main chain. So one condition is there, whatever the longest carbon chain is there, it may be straight or not, it may be straight or not. So let us take one example for that. So here if you consider, so this is the example, and you can check it once. So here what is the longest carbon chain? Here the chain which has max number of carbons, it is called longest carbon chain. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, only 4 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, here also only 4 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes, this is the longest carbon chain. This is the longest carbon chain. So here number of carbons in parent chain, how many carbons are there here? So here 5 carbons are there. Okay, so 5, that means root word is pent. So first of all you have to do like this. Okay, so this chain is not straight, it is crossed only. So here, whatever the chain, this is the parent chain. The chain may be straight or not, it is depends on conditions. Now here let us take another example. Okay, now look at here. So here, 1, 2, 3 only, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this will be the parent chain. This will be the parent chain. Okay, so parent chain. How many carbons are there in parent chain? You consider 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 are there. Okay, so here 7 is there. So number of carbons in parent chain, 7. What is the word root? Word root is hepta. Okay, so this is the way. First of all, we have to select the longest carbon chain, which may be straight or not. Okay, this is the first rule. So here, coming to second rule. So here, carbon atom or other atoms or other group of atoms. Which are not included in parent chain are called substituents. Okay, so whatever the carbon atom or other atoms or the group of atoms which are not included in the parent chain are called substituents. Let us take an example. So here, what is the parent chain? This is the parent chain. Okay, so this is the parent chain. This is parent chain. Now this is not involved in this parent chain. Now this is called as substituent. Okay, this is one example. And coming to the second example. Now you can consider here. Okay. Now what is the parent chain? Now this is the parent chain. So this is the parent chain. Now this is and this is and this is. All these are the. Now this is PC. Parent chain. This is substituent. This is also substituent. This is also substituent. Here carbon atoms or other atoms or group of atoms which are not included in this parent chain are called as the substituents. Okay. So now here let us take another example. Okay, So here also you can say that. So this is the parent chain, longest carbon chain, which may be straight or not. That is parent chain. So this is parent chain. Then this is substituent. This is also substituent. This is also substituent. This is also substituent. Okay. So this is about the second rule. So third rule. In case of two chains have same length, then the chain with more number of substituents considered as parent chain. Okay, if two chains are having the same length, then the chain with more substituents are considered as the parent chain. So let us consider here. So this is the chain. So look at the possibility here. This is the parent chain. This is the parent chain. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons are there. Okay. Now here again one more chain is also possible. So for this only, let me discuss once. 6. So you can see, you can observe here, which chain is possible here. This is also the possible. So look at the carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. Here 6 carbons are possible, here 6 carbons are also possible in the longest chain. So which one we have to take as the longest chain? Means here you consider the number of substituents. 1, 2, 3 only. 1 substituent, 2 substituent, 3 substituents. 1, 2, 3 only. But here number of substituents are 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So here, if two chains are possible with the same number of carbons as a parent chain, then we have to consider the chain with maximum number of the substituents. Now this is, so substituents are 4. Here substituents are 3 only. So this is considered as the parent chain. Okay. So this is not the parent chain. Okay. So whatever, if same number of carbons are possible for the parent chain, the chain with maximum number of substituents are considered as the parent chain. So this is the parent chain. So parent chain. Okay. This is not parent chain. Okay. Not parent chain. So the next rule is lowest Rocant rule. So lowest Rocant rule. Okay. So here, while numbering to parent chain, the number starts from as Rocant. Rocant, what is Rocant? So the carbon which is attached with the substituent is called Rocant. From as a Rocant should get least number. While numbering to parent chain, the number starts from as Rocant should get the least number. So let us take example for this. So here it is a substituent. Okay, this is the parent chain. So the carbon which is attached with the substituent is called as Rocant. Rocant, this is Rocant. Okay, Rocant should get the least number. From here, what number it will get? 1, 2, 3. Third number. Rocant is at the third. Means here the substituent is attached at the third carbon. From here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So from here, second carbon. So it means that lowest Rocant rule means Rocant should get the least number. So which one is correct? This one is the correct option. Okay, so numbering is start from this one. So whatever that, this one is wrong option. Okay. So let us take another example. So for example, here NO2 group is there. So here, now this is the parent chain. If you start numbering from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So third number, look at is at the third. So from starting here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here to here, the locant should get at the which carbon? Fourth carbon. So which one is correct? This one is only correct. Locant should get the least number. Now this one is wrong. So the next rule is lowest sum rule. Lowest sum rule. According to this, if two or more substituents are present, if two or more substituents are present, substituents are present, the numbering is given as the sum of locant values is low, and sum of locant values is low. For example, so here let us take, so here, so this is the way. Okay, so this is the way. So in this, how shall we give the numbering? So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is left to right. Then right to left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here, the locants from left to right. So the locants are at second place plus nazareth fourth place. So sum of the locants is 6. And right to left, the locants are at third place, Nazareth fifth place. The sum is A. So lowest sum rule. As per lowest sum rule, the sum of the values of the locants should be lesser. So this is possible. So which one is correct? Left to right numbering is the correct option. Okay. This is about lowest sum rule. So the next first point difference. Next one is first point difference. If for example, in a carbon chain, in a parent chain, two or more substituents are present. So first of all, we have to check from which side the locant is getting the lowest number. That most important point. So here, for example, now this is the parent chain. So this is the longest carbon chain. Here substituents are here. First of all, as per first point difference. First of all, if you start the numbering from left to right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the locant is at second. The locant is this second. Locant places means substituent is at second carbon. If it starts from right to left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here, the first locant carbon means the substituent is comes at the second, third place here. So here, locant third place. So compare. So as per the first point difference rule, so from which side the first substituent is getting the lowest number, means substituent attached carbon is getting the lowest number, that we have to consider. So this is the correct. As per first point difference, this is the correct. So if lowest sum rule is there and others first point difference is there, then it's better option to go to only first point difference. So this is the correct. Left to right is the correct. Okay. So this is the wrong option. So here next rule. So here two substituents are presented same position. For example, here C group is there. Here NO2 group is there. So two substituents are presented the same position. Means here from left to right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So from right to left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here these two are getting the same position. Then which one we have to consider? Let us see here. So compared to C means methyl. N means nitro. N means nitro. Which one comes first in alphabetical order? M. Okay. So that the numbering is from here to here. This is correct. So left to right numbering is the correct. So from left to right, what's the name of this one? Here. So here. 2-methyl 2 method. So while writing the name, the position and as well as the substituent between these two, we have to add a dash. Okay, so 2 means it refers the position of the substituents, means 2-methyl. And next, 4-nitro, pentane. Okay, this is the name. Okay, so here, while numbering, we have to, if two substituents are present at the same position, while numbering, you have to consider alphabetical order. Okay, and here, while writing the name, whatever the substituent is there, so the position of the substituent and as well as substituent, between the two, you have to add a hyphen. Okay, and the next one, for example, two or more substituents are present, same type of substituents are present. Here two substituents are same. Okay, so here we can give the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, at this time, at the second position and at the fifth position, these two positions you have chloro. So here chlorine, how many times it has come? 2. So we have to represent here di. If it has come 3 times, then you have to represent with the tri. 4 times tetra, 5 times penta. Okay, so here, listen, so 2, 5 at the second position and as well as this fifth position, you have chlorines. How many chlorines? Di. You have to write that di chloro hexane. This is also a rule. So in this rule, we discussed about the alphabetical order for numbering. If substituents are at same position. Okay, so this is this rule. And for this rule, if two are more same substituents are present, we represent them as prefix di or tri or tetra. Okay, after the numbering, while naming the compound, while naming IUPAC name for a compound, then also you have to go through the alphabetical order. So let us see here. So this is the compound. So first one is, which includes select the longest carbon chain. So which one is this? Is this is comes under the longest carbon chain, means nothing but parent chain. Okay, so first process. So the next we have to give the numbering. So from here, the substituent 1, 2, 3, your third position is substituent, but here your second position only substituent is there. First point difference 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So parent chain carbons are 8. So here what root is oct. Okay, and here substituents are at which places is there? Chloro is there, bromo is there, nitro is there, methyl is also there. So here first one, chloro is there, chloro. Next to bromo, next to methyl, next to nitro is there. So chloro at which position? Second position. And next, bromo is at position? Fifth position. Nitro is at which position? Fourth position. Sorry, nitro is the fourth position. Okay, and the next methyl is sixth position. Okay, now you have to, while writing the names, so substituents here, these are substituents. So here, while writing the names, you have to consider the alphabetical order. So C which one is comes first? So bromo. The next one, chloro. Second. The next one, third one is methyl. Fourth one is nitro. Alphabetical order. Okay. So now start naming. So here, which one is comes first? Bromo. So bromo is which position? 5. So 5, bromo. Next to 2, chloro. Next 6, methyl. Next 4, nitro. So here, oct in saturated octane. Okay, so club just rushes them to 5-bromo 2-chloro 6-methyl 4-nitro octane. So here this rule includes while writing IUPAC name of the compound, the name should be, by writing the IUPAC name of the compound, the substituents should be right as per alphabetical order. Okay, na? So this is about the rule. So these all are the basic, some of the basic and general rules for writing the IUPAC names. Okay.
థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్. ఈ వీడియో కనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి, కామెంట్ చేయండి, మన ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి.